And I think it, young people was one area. I mean, I've got a piece of work here which I didn't watch it. They were very, very frank, and the services they were very frank about, because I hadn't shared it with them yet. But I will be taking that back, because young people really were saying, we don't feel like anybody listens to us because we're younger, and some of the challenges that these young people have got. And so I think that ongoing engagement with those groups is really important, and also how we do communicate with people, understanding where we find people, how we get out there to them, and we think we're probably not the best people to do it all of the time. So we've done work with Community Action Wirral, we've talked to Health Watch, because they are often well placed to go out and have conversations with those groups, and we can then act upon what they've suggested. So I think we need to use different forms of media as well. So if you put something on YouTube now, my kids will watch YouTube all the time. So, you know, maybe that's the way we can pick up. Children with diabetes is a really good example. They do not want to engage. They don't even want to admit that they've got diabetes. But actually, we need to get to them because the consequences could be huge if we don't.
Okay, anybody else?
Really pleased that people care about our precious NHS. That's great. Yeah. In terms of, I just wanted to ask you a little bit more about the rural care record. So I know previously people have had concerns about kind of private insurance companies, if that information is going to be shared with them. So if you could answer something about that. And also, is it going to be an opt-in or probably an opt-out system?
It's looking like it'll be an opt-out, so you get the opportunity to opt-out, and you can always opt-in later again if you want to. We're having some discussions at the moment because there's some sort of more statutory groups of people which it's guidance says you should not share their data, so people with HIV, for example. We're challenging that and going, well, we'll ask them if they want their data included, because actually it might mean that they can get the treatment they need if they're unconscious in an emergency department. So I think as an adult, one of my jobs is to challenge things. But yes, those common concerns about, are they going to sell my data? Because that's something that I think we all get those nuisance calls, don't we? Are people anywhere else in the world going to be able to see it and have sort of view of my data? The company we're working with, they have to work to really strict regulations about what they do with data, and they absolutely cannot step out of line. But I think what we are going to do is put that in this whole consultation exercise we're doing to regionally ask questions. We're going to come out and talk to people, because we're very aware that in the past there have been other sort of systems that people haven't been happy with. That's why this was one of my first work streams. We've had all our information governance people involved, people from the council and from all the organisations, from the Information Commissioner's office, everywhere, to say, are you confident we're doing all the right things? And we haven't answered all the questions yet. We're still just boxing off consent and how we run that process, and also which groups we include, exclude. Yeah, we're very happy to come back and talk more about that, because it's so important.
Yeah, my question was more or less the same. Council Davies was, you know, the rural care records, who are we going to be partnership with, in collaboration with, what partners are we going to work with, you know, at the ambulance service, because it's really crucial that we have this rural care record, because, you know, in order for it to work, everyone needs to be able to access it, so I'm sure we're on board with that. And fantastic all the work that Bangor is doing, because, you know, we're on Councillor Buckland just informed you that we are doing a fantastic finish on hospital admissions, so we can see on the single front door to the community integrated, you know, the integration hubs. And you know, we need lots more of those integration hubs. So we talk about community assets, and is that what you can see?
Yes, I think it's about, we've got four hubs. I think it's about how those grow and develop. One of the big links with the relationship with the GPs, because actually GPs at the moment, they're so tied up in delivering services, but it's really challenging for them, they're so busy. But we want to say, well, how can we help you by supporting very plain was that if people know where to get information from, they'll go and do it. And so actually, you know, if it was a medicine for a dog, just go and get this medical help you with your skin condition. It saves a call to the GP. The other point you made about data, whose data is going in the World Care Record, we're bringing this in phases. So the first phase that will go live over the summer is hospital data and GP data. And the reason they've gone first is simply because their data systems are the most sort of mature and able to switch in first, followed straight on by the Community Trust because we realise how important their data is as well. Then the Mental Health Trust and Social Care data. So it makes it sound very simple how we connect those together. I can't tell you how we're trying to get five different ideas to enjoy us.
There's a strategy of this government to increasingly devolve things. Sooner or later, health and social care may be the issue. I'm concerned that the reforms and changes you set up in the world may not cut across to the other areas of it. My concern is that we're setting up a system which is going to have to be changed or disregarded once health and social care is devolved to the nursing side.
If it's
something to be taken into consideration.
I think that's why I mentioned the sustainability transformation plan. I think it's a recognition that there are a number of discussions going on. What I would say is our team are about the person and the local population, because I think whatever happens across a wider footprint, most of your health and social care, if you live on Wirral, will be delivered here. And so we are working with further sort of areas. So if you have tertiary care in Liverpool, for example, if you have cancer in the oncology centre. Mm-hmm. But we're very patient focused, and it's around the patient journey or the person's journey. I don't know whether, do you want to add any more?
I've been involved in quite a lot of discussions around the Wallasey region in terms of the health and social care devolution and setting up the CCG committee in common. Basically, most services that we deliver in terms of mainstream services like the hospital, the sort of stuff you've been talking about today, are delivered much more effectively on a local footprint. So going forward, the STP, the plan, will be about there's a big chunk of services delivered very locally. And the governance of that needs to be local, and the kind of, if you like, the patient insight in terms of personal insight in terms of what needs to be delivered needs to be local. There are some things that may be better delivered on a broad footprint, and some of that's about what we call specialist commissioning, so where you've got a lower volume for quite complicated services. So I think that those conversations are open at this point in time in terms of what that
accessed in any way by different areas within what may be the kind of city region. I can envision there being an IT problem where if we're not careful, if our system is not so advanced, it leaves places in the dust of our similar investment.
Is it something that you would prefer would be referred to somebody else?
Yes, I think we might have
to be at a different level.
Yeah. I mean, I know what you're saying, but maybe we consider it.
It's probably something that needs to be done.
Yes,
Wendy, and then Steve.
One update since then is provided in December 2014, but social worker is hopefully happy with it to a new worker. But with our new social work teams that we put in place in June of last year, where the children and the care teams, we no longer have a split or separation at 16 to move to a new pathway worker. You have your same social worker that sees you through. Our big challenge is to make sure we've got a sufficiently stable social work workforce, because one of the big things that children in care do say
itself where we found it very enlightening. And what, I mean, it mentions the three of us. I must say that we have, I think we mentioned in the report, 20 meetings with various groups. And it was marvellous. I've said this before, but I don't mind saying it again. I thought Alan Burgess did a great job on getting down on our findings. Because you know, interviewing and getting all the things out. The kernel of what we discovered was came out in the report, and we're very pleased. It's just as relevant today as the day we put that together. What I think what has been pleasing is that there were things that we needed to address. And one of the parts I think has been great is to find that the things that we did discover that were weaknesses in our system have been addressed, and you know, on the green, on schedule. And I suppose the only question one would ask is, where we're on amber, and I know that the plans are put to deal with those things, how long do you think before we can say we're 100%?
I'm not supposed to say it now, at the end, when people have made their contribution, what I'm going to suggest to committee is that we have another short review to see what the children themselves think about how the outcomes have improved as a result of these recommendations. And the suggestion is that we invite members of the children of the children subcommittee to be part of that review, with Wendy chairing it as she chaired the original thing. Out, but I'll be there as well, obviously. But
yeah, thanks very much.
But David, did you want to say something?
Yes, as an adopted child from a very early age, I was to put out for leaving care with the slightly different, but having the right parents bringing you up, making you feel wanted and valued and all those kind of things, so I'm pretty supportive of it. I have to be honest, I think the staying home policy is to be superb. And the only sort of caveats that I have around the staying home policy, does it skew you? And the other thing was, does this, I think somebody mentioned before, does it bed block? So by having people who effectively staying on, as it were, does it stop those foster places? That's the only question. But I think it's like a fabulous thing.
We'll take the three comments and then we'll go Treena and Janette.
Thanks, Chair. I just want to say, you know, big thanks to the Task and Finish Group for doing this from deep water. I think it's absolutely brilliant report, and I mean, it was really emotional to read the post 16 support comments on issues such as, you know, it's silly at the age of 18 and to assume that you're okay to be on your own because, you know, you're not ready. And, you know, and there's lots of initiatives that were taken from that through the Pathways team, such as partnership with social landlords, which is fabulous, the youth defending team, job centre plus. And, you know, still loads of good work to be built upon, and I know that it is continuing. I know that I've had meetings with Linda Davies and we've got some apprenticeships, and we're looking to, you know, do some of the Tramway Rovers. So all of these are, you know, I know there's lots of work that is going on, so that, you know, thanks to everyone.
Walter, would you mind switching your microphone on? I think you've just, Walter.
Sorry.
Children said my mum, which was great, and I said, "Wow, consistent are we in keeping a social worker involved with that child in those circumstances where they are changing their care?
Yeah, just a quick one, Mr. Chair. I know people may know this because I'm not normally on this committee. But there's something about aspirations which was very interesting, and the comments that you just mentioned on plastic goes. Wasn't there a scheme that they finished on called Aim Higher, which was supposed to get rid of all those things? Was that not finished?
Maybe
perhaps
not
having any
education.
Yeah,
that's
what Aim Higher was called. I was trying to get.
social work team dealing